line item graph theorists are not particularly clever, but people who do think about graph theory, and in particular topologists, are. So let me talk. Here's an outline. I'm going to be talking about finite graphs, infinite graphs, and possibly some. Okay. But this is all a particular kind of graph theoretic question. So I'm going to be talking about Hamilton decompositions. Decompositions is a long word that they make us learn to take the GRE before going to grad school. It really means a colouring. So I like colours, that's why I've been colour short and all of this stuff would be about colouring graphs. So I guess I should define a Hamilton cycle in a graph, Kevin has already mentioned. You have a collection of vertices. It's a cycle that goes through every one of the vertices exactly once. And so a graph G is, decomposable. Is a Hamilton cycle. A Hamilton cycle as illustrated by this small example. So, the reason why, the motivation part is always difficult for any maths tool, but sort of the main thing we could say about it is it's something people have done before, and it's kind of rare in graph theory. Especially that we can talk about one point across just because it's really equivalent to what we're supposed to do. So, this is a theorem from as far back as 1890. This is like before Turing. And I don't really know anything before Turing. I guess, maybe like algebra and analysis, but yeah, this is a classic. you have to relativize everything. So k to k plus 1 is Hamilton decomposable. This is quite a cute old result. So why do I write k to k plus 1? Oh, I guess I should say this. This is a big graph. On 2k plus 1 vertices. We can't possibly hope to have this when the number of vertices is even, because then the degrees are going to be odd and the cycle must have two edges to every vertex. Mumble, mumble, parrot, mumble. But this is true for when there's an odd number of vertices. This is a decomposition of K-pi. The outer pedagogy is a Hamilton cycle and the into graphs that look like they have Hamilton cycles. This seems like a natural process for building cycles, for building graphs that might have this decomposition property. At least that's what we kind of hope, but there is a ridiculous open conjecture to this effect. Well, the degrees add, right? It should be easy if they're both odd and complete, but I can't do colors and cartesian products in my head, so I will say probably.
Some fancy graph, but it has a fixed number of vertices, and it's a lot of like big folded all. Can you do the product or not?
Oh, as in like I fix in advance my choose only by trying.
Or something, yeah. Yeah.
I think that includes some of these special boxes that are sporadic. It seems to become very, very difficult to suit perfectly the number of those. I mean, it's so easy to define things. I've done it in, what, 15 minutes.
There must be some sort of restriction. If I take, Zmod 4Z with everything as a generator on the A4.
So, Zmod 4Z with... I want to avoid having parallel edges for precisely this reason.
So a generating set, so groups that exists, groups in a generating set.
I'll write it again. I guess I should note, there is a similar thing that is also, this is sort of the 9/10 of the conjecture. The additional 1/10 is, if you allow this to be non-empty, but when you simplify the graph upon getting some parallel edges, every vertex still has even degree, then you could still keep it. So, I just didn't want to worry about local conditions that might get in the way. I knew you'd pick up on it because you always spot these things faster than I can think about them. Yeah, assuming that it's what you expect it to be.
I don't know. I feel like Z6 with 1 and 2 address.
Generating set actually tells us that the graph has to be connected. We need to be able to get it everywhere from zero, and saying that I can generate an arbitrary element of the group starting from elements of S means precisely that I can get to.
Well, instead of 1 and 2, 1 and 2, you should have like.
Oh,
I think we're still
how on earth can the white ray be connected? It's got to touch all of the vertices to the right, and it's got to touch all of the vertices to the left. So it can't be connected. It's got to cross somewhere. But instead, suppose that there are two edges of one color and one edge of another color. What happens to the white graph in this instance? Well, it's got to be connected somehow. So either it's connected long as we can continue making small finite changes to these infinite double rays and not accidentally leaving some loops inside, then I can leave very large pieces of the graph as they are, modify some other things in such a way that actually these two particular rays end up becoming the same component. So a single switch like this, for example, just like one of the squares over here, now changes this into a single component, this into a single component, and this and this into a single component. Okay, it doesn't look as though I decreased the number of components in any way here. Well, that would have been quite difficult since there are infinitely many of them. But all I need to do is grow such a region in which all of the stuff inside that region are the same component. And if I do this infinitely many times, then the result will make it happen. So I guess for small finite changes, I'm going to define an almost that's